Hi guys, so for today's video I wanted to bring you an Amazon wig haul. So lately I've been obsessed with Amazon wigs. It took me a while to buy one because I didn't know what to expect. I'd read a lot of reviews and then I started watching other YouTube videos about them, so I was finally convinced enough to purchase an Amazon wig. So if you want to see a couple of styles that I've purchased, some in different colors of the same wig, then just keep watching. So naturally I'm gonna start off with the one I'm wearing. This wig is super blonde and it's described as 613, which is a color shade of blonde. It's one of the lighter shades of blonde and it is my favorite so far. Honestly, I've had to wear this like almost daily. It's really, really nice. So I will bring up the info on my phone and I will also link the wigs below if you want to purchase them yourself. So for this one, it's a longer wig and it's got some waves in it. I've brushed her out several times. I'll get to that in a moment, but so far so good. She is a lace front. She has a little bit of lace in the front here, and I truly feel like this is a beginner's lace front wig, and it is amazing. It's so thick and full and I'm absolutely in love with it. So I'm probably gonna butcher the company name, but it starts with a K and it's like K-Krisma. So Krisma, I don't know, Krisma. Sorry, I'm totally butchering that. But that is the brand and it's a natural looking ash blonde wig. And it's the, I purchased it in 26 inches. It comes in a few different inch sizes. There might be some that are not available currently, but the ones that are available are 22, 24, and 26 inches. And the current price, I won't say because price fluctuates on Amazon so often, but it's in the 30s. So I think it's totally worth it. I love it. I barely had to do anything with the lace. I didn't glue it down or anything, so it's not super fancy right now, but I have tried it and it looks amazing. Yeah, that's all I can pretty much say about it. As you can see, I have all the hair in the front. I'm actually gonna go with blonde for a while now. As you'll see when I show you the other wigs, I have so many different colors and a lot of them were not natural, and I've just been obsessed. I've been obsessed with the not natural colors, but this blonde is actually pretty natural looking to me and I'm loving it. Okay guys, so for this wig, I have this exact wig in like four different colors and I'll show you all the colors and I'll put in a little bit of tidbits for each color because the company is the same but the quality shifts depending on the color, and there's some that are thicker, some that could use a little more something, but this one in particular I think it's pretty perfect. This is the Netgo black wig, long kinky curly wavy hair. It says it's heat friendly. I haven't tried heat on it at all, but this is what it's looking like, and it's on the more affordable side, so I'll say it's in the low 20s. I do have the bangs to the side, but I've worn them like straight like that. But I like it to the side. It's not in my, all up in my face, and these bangs in particular are pretty nice. I don't know if I've actually even touched these bangs as far as cutting or trimming or anything, but this one I remember it being pretty perfect as is. It's another long one. It's pretty long. The curls are in it are really nice. I've brushed it out a little bit and added a little bit of product, but for the most part, it's gotten its own little kinky wave thing going on right now. I forgot to mention with the blonde one, it does shed. I think any synthetic wig shed, because guess what? It's not growing out of your head, so it's going to shed. And even our own hair sheds. But it's nothing crazy. This one I feel sheds a little bit more. And plus the texture kind of causes it, because you kind of want to run your hands through it. But it's also super, super thick. The parting I did mess with a little bit, just put a little bit of concealer and powder and stuff like that, but not too much, just because I don't need to mess with it that much. I don't feel the need to. I really don't care if people say, oh, it's a wig. I don't. This one is really pretty. I like it a lot. It's very versatile. Sometimes I kind of tuck it behind my ear, just making sure that, you know, my hairline looks good. So yeah, so this one's pretty cute. I'm not gonna lie, this is a good everyday wig. I like to pop this on and I have to run out really quick and I don't have my natural hair done, which I've been kind of giving a break, so that's why I've been wig crazy, because I've been kind of hiding my own hair just to give it a break. And I'm gonna show you the other colors of this same brand and same style wig. Okay guys, so as you can see, I have the brown one on now. Now this one is the light brown. So I guess there's a dark brown color of this wig, but this is the light brown. And I picked this just based on pictures in the reviews. I don't wanna say this is my favorite, and I have a few reasons why. Now the actual rest of the hair aside from the bangs is really, really cool. The curls are really nice. It's a little less kinky than the black one. I know that happens with some colors. The texture does vary, so that's totally true with this one. This one's not my favorite in this particular style. And it's not the style itself, it's just the color. This particular color, and there's another one that kind of reminds me of this one, but as far as the thickness is around the rest of the head, it's really nice. It's nice and thick. I don't see any tracks or anything that are super noticeable. I'm sure if you lifted it up, you can see it. But again, it's just I think it's just the bangs that really turned me off to this one. I've worn it out a couple times and I've really, you know, not cared if anyone noticed that the bangs were wiggy looking. But yeah, I just wanna work with it a little bit more so that I like it more. I forgot to mention with this one, there are no clips or anything. You can attach some if you want to, but there's only adjustable straps on this one. So I am wearing a wig headband to kind of hold it and grip it in place, but the cap itself kind of expands a bit, so it holds onto your head really nicely and it has a nice grip, so I really don't feel the need to do the clips myself. Okay guys, so this one right here, this is totally Ariel vibes. So I don't know if I mentioned that the black one was the first one I purchased, but that was my bad. But this is actually the first one I purchased of this style, and it's just the red version of this wig. Again, I'll link all the colors below. I don't know if it'll bring you to that specific color. This particular color has been a favorite of mine, I'm not gonna lie. I really, really, I don't know, it's just the perfect shade of red. Like if I had naturally red hair, this is the color I'd want. Again, it's super long, and right now I have it tucked, you know, behind the ears a little bit. One night, excuse my nails, they really need to be done. But yeah, so I have it kind of tucked behind the ear on the sides. If I were to wear this outside, I'd put bobby pins in it and kind of make it look as if it was my hair. The thickness in it isn't as thick as the black and the brown. I don't know if that's kind of your mind playing tricks on you because the red is so obvious. The wig cap itself is a nude color on all of these, I believe. So if you do expose it's obvious when you expose the tracks or the wig cap. So just be careful with that. But other than that, I am seriously loving this red color. And I love the bangs. I've actually trimmed them a bit because they are so long, but I really like the way I trim them. I really like the way they look now. It's one of those easy to customize wigs, which is really why I like these with the bangs, because then you can just put it on and not have to worry about kind of blending your own hairline with it. This is just good to go as is. All right, so this is the last one of this particular style, and it's around the same price range in the 20s right now currently on Amazon. Again, it's the NetGo brand, and it is the one with the bangs. There's a lot of colors offered with this particular style, and I might buy some more, who knows. I've already bought four, so I'm kind of, you know, obsessed. Anyway, this is the pink version of that wig. There's a couple of issues with this wig that I've had. I am still trying to work with this, the latest one I've purchased, so I haven't had as much time to work with it. But one of the things that I love is actually the color. I love this color pink. Like, I don't have any pink wigs, so this is my first one, and I absolutely adore this color. One of the issues I have with it are the bangs. Now, I have them sideswept a little bit right now, but they're kind of got a weird curve in them, which I can solve by actually using like a curling iron on a low heat setting, but I haven't tried that yet. I do intend on doing that. And then another thing is, it's not that thick. It definitely has more exposure on the sides. Like, I've got it pretty good right now. However, if I lazily tucked it behind my ear, you would definitely be able to see my own natural hair or the tracks themselves. So I'm still working with this one, but it looks so cute. I do love the way she looks, especially right now. I'm kind of looking like, okay, I see you. I see you, Pinky. So yeah, so I'm just gonna work with this one a little bit more, but I am not knocking it. I wouldn't be on here suggesting you buy it or suggesting you take a look if I didn't like it. I do absolutely love it. I just gotta work on it a little more. But yeah, here's the pink one. Okay, y'all. this girl. Now let's talk about this particular wig. First of all, I am a long hair girl. Like, if you can't tell by now, I love my long wigs, wavy, curly, sometimes straight, but I gotta be in the mood for it. So I do lean more towards the longer wigs. But this one in particular, I don't know what it was about it, but it caught my eye, and especially the color. So the color itself is called Mix Blue by the brand Sun Hour, and it's the wavy wig, short bob wig with air bangs. It's got a long description, but again, I will link it down below. This one in particular, I looked at it in a different color, but this color just caught my eye and I just could not get it in this color. I love blue. Ever since I did the D wig in the blue color, it's like a turquoise blue color, I've been obsessed with that one. So I decided to go ahead and bite the bullet and buy this one, and it is on the lower end of the price range. It's around 20-ish right now, currently on Amazon. But anyway, I love the bangs on this. I might have trimmed them, but I think they came pretty well as is. So as I was saying, my battery died, so I had to change. So I apologize if the actual picture has shifted a little bit, but this one is everything. Like, this wig is everything. I would have never thought I'd be purchasing like a short wig, let alone something like this. It is very fantasy looking. It's not natural at all, but I absolutely love it. I would wear this outside, yes, on a normal day. I don't care. I do have it tucked behind my ear a little bit just because I prefer it that way. It does give it a little more bump and a little more volume when you do something like that. The bangs themselves, I really haven't had to mess with too much. I can't say anything really bad about this wig. Anyway, look at this one. I'm just obsessed with this color and the style and everything. So yes, highly recommend this one. Again, it's the Sun Hour in the color Mixed Blue, and I will link it down below as well. Something I did notice messing with the bangs in front here is that you can see the tracks if you aren't super careful. So just be careful. They're thick enough to wear, I mean, unless you're like really all up in somebody's head, which you shouldn't be anyway, you shouldn't be able to notice. Anyway, before I ramble on too much, I'm gonna go ahead and say see you next time. If you have any suggestions on wig videos or any video type, just go ahead and comment below. I hope this helps you out if you're considering purchasing these wigs. Turn that notification bell on if you want to be notified as soon as I upload, and I'm going to try to get more consistent with uploading, so please do so. It'll kind of pressure me into doing that as well. Have a great day, and I'll see you guys next time.